And rancor and war, we next turn to a man who is working to give us a way to find peace. Since the age of four, Prem Rawat has been going around the world to reintroduce people to what peace within feels like. But he himself has not escaped the sting of controversy. Still, despite the challenges facing all of us, Rawat says the antidote is so simple that even a young child can understand.
Pick the light. It'll automatically take care of the darkness.
Prem Rawat is one of the most famous speakers in the world that you may never have heard of. The New York Times best-selling author travels the world all year long, teaching people how to access inner peace and contentment. When did you start speaking about peace? How old were you?
I was 4 years old.
Four?
Four.
And would people listen to a four-year-old?
Actually, they did. They did, because they couldn't believe a four-year-old was talking about peace. So they would hear this little child talking, and they would just come running to see what was going on. And I could at least get a few words in. I didn't have any idea of what this huge audience was or what these people were really there for, but I knew I wanted to talk about peace.
A four-year-old has oftentimes difficulty forming a sentence, never mind sitting in front of a crowd of hundreds and thousands of people talking about peace. Where did the words come from?
The word came from an inspiration that's inside that really says, you know, there is a possibility that is above and beyond all our things that are going on in this world. We are so wrapped up in all the goods and bads of every single day that we forget there is another possibility. And that possibility is the possibility to be fulfilled.
Rawat did not come from humble beginnings. His early life looked like almost none other. His father was a guru in India, and Rawat followed in his father's footsteps. Controversy eventually followed, initially due to labels Rawat was given. So when you first sort of started this journey as a young boy, people would call you things like the perfect master. And what that conjures up in my mind and many people's mind is this a cult? So is it what you are doing and spreading and the people who follow your message?
I will tell you something that I can say. I cannot tell you why they say what they said. All I can tell you is what I can say, what I see, what I have always felt. And what I have always felt is this is not about me. This is about them. This is about them finding themselves. That's the journey I am on, helping people find themselves. And I want to be on that journey too, finding myself.
In 1972, he left India to take his message to the West, arriving in London at just 13 years old. Back then, he was called Guru Maharaji. His following exploded. And decades later, so again, did controversy. A small group of former followers began questioning how he can afford to live a lavish lifestyle, like having a private jet that he pilots himself, and a mansion in Malibu. A representative for Rawat says he is not living a lavish lifestyle. His Malibu property was purchased when land was cheap in the 70s, and Rawat spends at least 9 months of the year on commercial and leased planes, traveling to speak with hundreds of thousands of people all over the globe, with the simple goal of offering a way to find peace. His charitable foundation spending is transparent, and an independent organization that rates charity spending has consistently given the foundation a high rating. Over the past half century, Rawat has traveled to every continent, speaking about finding personal peace. His foundation has provided millions of meals to the hungry in recognition that peace is not possible if you don't have the necessities of life. His peace program is also being used in schools and more recently for inmates in prisons in Africa and the United States, with the sole goal of giving people a way to feel peaceful inside. He's been given keys to multiple cities across the globe for his work to bring people peace. And he's received numerous awards, including the Brand Laureate International Hall of Fame Lifetime Achievement Award.
Thank you so much. I'm very touched by the whole ceremony today.
An award given to the likes of Nelson Mandela.
You have so sacrificially given your life and your all in promoting peace to the world.
But Rawat insists this is not about him. It's about you. It's about peace.
We are seeing right on the doorstep of Europe, a war has started again. And it seems that we go back to this every time there's a conflict. It is a direct line to fight or flight, and we tend to pick fight. So how is it possible to have peace in this world?
The idea of peace has coexisted along the side with wars and all the controversies that we have had in this world. Peace, we have to find it within ourselves. Only then will it manifest outside. Just as with wars, it first begins in the minds of human beings, and then it goes and manifests outside. The dissatisfaction that we feel in us, we see it projected all around us. This is not something that the buildings put up. This is not something that the roads put up. This is human beings putting it up.
So are you saying that the internal conflict that we have has to be dealt with before we're able to have so-called world peace? I mean, how do you do that?
Well, you have to just get in touch with yourself. You have a phone. It communicates with everybody else. How do you communicate with you? Know thyself was no mistake. It echoes even today. With all the technology, if we don't have the technology of getting in touch with ourselves.
And I think that is where we will leave it. That's hard to do, to make that choice, but I suppose that it's necessary to find that peace, especially the inner peace. Prem Rawat, thank you so much for joining our show.
Thank you so much for having me. Thank you.